Good morning, this is Andrew McAfee, and this is another video from hornlessons.org. Today I'm going to talk about intonation and fingerings. I've talked in previous videos about the importance of holding the air always at the bottom of the note, the bark point, and you can see those videos and hear what they're talking about. This is putting it into practice. If you're playing a chord, we're talking chordal intonation here, not melodic intonation like a piano, but chordal intonation, you're going to need to utilize the information on this page. This is basically the harmonic series of how our universe resonates. So if you look here, the F horn has the C, E, and G already built in to its natural overtone series. And the C, playing it open, no valves, should be right in tune. If you tune your horn, you know, to 440 or whatever it is, that is the best note to tune it to. The first, second, fourth, and eighth overtones ring true. But if you go up to the E, you will see that it rings, if you play it open, and if you play with the air at the bottom of the groove, it will ring 14 cents flat. And if you play the G, it will ring 2 cents sharp. Now, what the cents mean is, in a half step, like from F to E or B to C to B, there are 100 cents in a half step. So that is the sort of the distance of 14% of the distance between a half step. So if you look over here, this is a C major chord or F concert, which would resonate perfectly with our harmonic series here. And if you're going to play this chord in tune, the C, bang, open, right in tune. And if you want these other notes to ring true to the C, you need to play them open as well, because they need to be exactly as the harmonic series expresses itself. The E, 14 cents flat, and the G, 2 cents sharp, exactly how it is here. So if you play all of these notes open, they should ring together if you are playing with the airstream at the bottom of the groove. Of course, if you play the E, thumb and second, that note is going to be in tune with a piano, but it's going to be 14 cents too sharp to play in a chord. Which brings up the other comment: when you're playing in an orchestra and you're tuning to a concert A, yes, you want to use thumb and second on your E, and no, you do not want to use an open E, because that's going to be 14 cents flat. So let's look at a couple of other keys that we're going to go to. Let's just move right up here to what's called the concert B flat overtone series with your thumb valve down. So let's say you have an F, A, and C chord. Yes, if you push the thumb valve down, all of these notes would ring together. And in fact, you can have this concept in general, that if you're going to play any of these notes together, play them on the thumb valve and they will ring naturally together in tune. It's the same principle. This needs to be in tune. That needs to be 14 cents flat as the major third. And the C is the fifth of the chord, needs to be 2 cents sharp. Let's just move right down. If you're playing an A major chord, or E major on the horn, E, G sharp, and B, you play them all thumb and second. They will ring true together. E flat major, or concert A flat, thumb and one, and the G is thumb and one. D major, or concert G, you play this thumb one and two, the F sharp, thumb one and two. G flat, or D flat major on the horn, thumb 2 and 3, the F, thumb 2 and 3, the A-flat, thumb 2 and 3. You get how this goes. This, of course, is much more logical down here for most people. B major is all second valve, all first valve, one and two. So that's just scratching the surface of intonation, and we can move it out further to the dominant seventh, which needs to be 31 cents flat, for the B flat here, which occurs naturally in the overtone series, and et cetera, for larger distances. One of my favorites is the major sixth interval between the A and the C. The A needs to be 16 cents flat, and that can be expressed if you're looking. Here's your G to an E. This is the E needs to be flat, of course, and the G is 2 cents sharp. But if you correct that and you bring this down 2 cents, you bring this down two more cents, it'll be perfectly 16 cents flat. So anyway, I'm getting a little bit off the topic and a little more complicated, but the relationships are the same. So I hope this is helpful for you to play better in tune and applying the concept of holding the air at the bottom of the groove and having more consistency and solidity in your day-to-day playing. Thank you.